Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
I am a bull terrier breeder. I am a houndsman and just a working dog enthusiast. Hog hunting, it's just kind of something I just picked up on my own. I didn't grow up hunting, you know. I don't come from a hunting family. My family's from the city. It's just something that I built on my own. I fell in love with watching my Jack Russells hunt as we used to run out in the hills. As we got better at hunting stuff, you know, they would hunt rabbits, squirrels. As I got older, I wanted to get into bigger game. So that's how, you know, with the Jack Russells, it was, you know, it wasn't very, it didn't get as good as it did when I got my hounds. Once I got into hounds, it just took off next level. Hounds, their genetics is just, it's all there. You really don't have to teach them much. It's what you can bring out of them, you know, using their genetics and what you could bring out. So a hound is gonna, you know, genetically put its nose to the ground and just follow whatever, you know, whatever it is. So as for me, I had no clue. I started hog hunting with just Jack Russells and my bull terriers. And it wasn't up until I met, you know, some houndsmen that they showed me, you know, what a hound was, how they work. And that's what made me, you know, get my first one. And hog hunting, for me, it wasn't as, you know, I wasn't as successful with just, you know, the dogs that I had up until I had the hounds. So the hounds that I use, it's really nothing in particular. I use more of crosses, like just honestly mutts. I have a few Catahoulas with, you know, hound blood in them. Say one of my Catahoulas is Catahoula Walker and Blue Tick. Those are some of the heavy, big game hounds in them. The ones that I use now, one of my really good dogs is a Catahoula Redbone, I believe. And my second best dog right now is a Trig Hound and McNab cross. So that's a fast running hound with a cattle dog cross, which for hogs, it's really good. They're really fast dogs. They're really smart. They can stop a hog well. You know, their cattle instincts is just natural. They like to herd animals. I don't like to use like heavy purebred big game hounds because they a lot of times they're really open on track, which means they're barking a lot. Once they start smelling something, they bark. For hogs, I don't really like them to bark too much. I like to use a more silent dog. Barking may, a hound that's open, it may work for like cats, lions and stuff. You know, animals that can climb up trees. You know, they hear the barking and they just climb up a tree and then you really don't got a long race. But for a hog can't really climb a tree. It's got no choice but to run. So if you got a dog that's barking too much, chasing a hog, you might be going on a 20-mile, you know, mission after that hog. And if you got a more silent dog that's, you know, right on it, the pig might not know, hey, it's still being pursued. So, you know, you got more chances of it stopping. And then, you know, you got a shorter race. In addition to my hounds, I use the traditional catch dog, you know, just kind of on a leash. I've been using the bull terriers for, you know, as long as I've been hunting. First, because I just had the dogs, you know, those are the bulldogs that I had, the strong breed that I had. But, you know, as time went on, I just started liking, you know, how they are. They got a huge mouth. They got a, you know, very strong grip. they got high pain tolerance. They will not let go. That's very important when you know dealing with a big hog. You don't want a dog to, you know, let go for no reason. You want them to stay on. A bull terrier, you know, that's what they do. You know, a lot of people use the American pit bull terrier, and I've used them before. Since the pit bull, it's more of a fighting dog. You know, they tend to use fighting dog tactics on a hog, which, you know, for fighting another dog, it's not bad. You know, they'll grab front legs, they'll swap holds to get like a strategy on fighting a hog, and which that's not really good. You want a dog to just get control of the head, hold the hog down by the head, and just hold it. A lot of times the American pit bull terrier is trying to fight it, you know, tugging and doing a lot of stuff. The bull terriers, for me, I've seen, they just like to hold and that's it. You know, they'll hang on. They're not trying to, you know, move around and you know. So that's one of my preferences. They're not too big. My bull terriers run between, you know, the biggest, I'd say 45, 50 pound. For my area that I hunt, it's very thick. I don't like carrying a big dog, you know, having a big dog pulling me around the woods. That's just, you know, it can get tiring. So I like to use the bull terriers. They're small. A lot of the stuff that we hunt is very thick. Bull terriers can get in there. They're not too big. I've seen big dogs get stuck, get tangled, and in the thick stuff, in the briars. And so yeah, it's been good that, you know, the little dogs are good. You don't really need too big of a dog. You know, once you start getting into big dogs, you might have them gas out and stuff like that, or they can't take the heat as well. So I've learned with the smaller dogs, you know, you got a lot of advantages. You can, you know, they take the heat. They're not, you know, they don't quit on you. The bull terrier, I mean, a small dog on a big animal like a hog, it's, you know, you got to have mentally strong dogs for sure. You know, I've never seen one that I've kept fail or, you know, not want to catch. I've seen other breeds, specifically the pits. I've seen many pits, you know, just not take the job well. I've seen them, you know, they might want to fight a dog or whatever, but they see a pig and it's just, you know, mentally it's like, whoa, you know, it makes them think twice. It's a big animal. You know, they really don't never seen one before. But for a bull terrier, I've always seen they're, you know, they're tenacious. They're game. They want that big animal usually. So most of the areas that I hunt are very, very, very thick, you know, so the size of them has been perfect. If you ever need to carry a dog over something, you know, you ain't carrying a big 80 pound dog. 45 pounds, you know, they can get in those holes that the hogs, you know, like to run in, tunnels and stuff. They can get in there well. So the difference between a show bull terrier or, you know, AKC, whatever, and a working line, mostly size. You know, those AKC ones, they like to have them, you know, thick chested, big round dogs. As for me, my working line is just thinner, you know, deeper chest, thin waist, you know, more legs on them. And that big, I mean, I've had big dogs before, and we go back to, you know, can they take the heat? You know, can they breathe right? You know, can they get over obstacles? You know, sometimes you're walking around the woods, you're stepping over stuff. You need a dog that can, you know, can jump over stuff, get under stuff, you know, really walk with you instead of you having to help them over any obstacles. Bullet is one of my puppies that I recently kept from a litter out of Luna, which she's out of a different kennel, and Grim, which is from my blood. So yeah, Bullet is the first, you know, one of the first, I'd say he's the next generation of dogs from me in this kennel. Lucy is a Catahoula red bone, as far as I know. Very good dog. She is, you know, my lead hound. She is, you know, she'll go wherever. She'll pick up hour-old, you know, three-hour-old track, she will do anything to figure out a track. She takes her time. She is my main tracker right now. Spanky, he is my trig hound McNab cross. He is Lucy's right-hand man, basically. You know, he's there with her at all times. Whenever I see them on the GPS, whenever I see them on the same line together, that usually tells me something's getting found. You know, if they're on the same track, something's getting found. You know, Lucy is the finder. Spanky is the fast one, the rougher dog. He's just a little more, you know, a little more rough than Lucy. You know, Lucy's got the nose. Spanky's got the grip, the speed. We're gonna wrap it up. I encourage people to get out there and work your dogs. You know, whatever it is, get out there. It keeps you young, you know, keeps you in shape, keeps you outdoors, you know. And if you hunt, it keeps you self-sufficient. You don't need to rely on somebody to feed you. If you know, it's very important, I think, as far as people knowing how to hunt and just getting their own food. You know, we might not have the luxury of a supermarket, you know, especially with everything going on in the world right now. We might not have that in the future. So getting out and knowing the world is good, where the food is at, what trees give you, what, you know, just knowing nature, it's beautiful.